Hello and welcome back to Insightsias. In today's discussion, we shall have a look at one of the oldest disputes in the Asian region, which is the dispute over the South China Sea. Well, the dispute which is nearly two centuries old and involves claims by at least six countries over the islands and maritime region doesn't seem to have a solution yet. Despite involvements by various countries including India and the USA and even from the Permanent Court of Arbitration, China is not loosening its stand over the disputed region. So now, why is this topic relevant for our exam? There are three reasons. Firstly, it is the geographical location of the South China Sea and the neighboring countries. At the end of this discussion, you should be able to locate important countries surrounding the South China Sea and various straits or gulfs in this region. Secondly, aggressive moves by the Chinese government are in violation of the United Nations Convention on the Law of Sea. So you should be knowing what is the UN clause and what is the exclusive economic zone. And thirdly, you should know what is the Permanent Court of Arbitration. Why? Because in 2016, this Court of Arbitration ruled in favor of Philippines over the dispute between the China and Philippines. Okay, let us start the discussion with map reading first. Where is South China Sea? It is located to the south of China. And what are the important countries surrounding this China Sea? And starting from China itself, we have China in number 1, Vietnam, Malaysia, Indonesia, Philippines and Taiwan. So let me repeat, which are the 6 countries involved in the region? China, Vietnam, Malaysia, Indonesia, Philippines and Taiwan. And since Hong Kong is in news because of the ongoing protests for years, please also understand and locate the Hong Kong on the map. And next, try to locate the Gulf of Tonkin. Where is it? It is located between Vietnam and the Hainan province of China. So after this Gulf of Tonkin, going further to the south of the Chinese Hainan province, we have Paracel Islands, which is claimed both by the Vietnamese government as well as the China. And please note that these Paracel Islands fall within the 9 dash line drawn by the Chinese government. So what is this 9 dash line? Please note that it is not an internationally recognized demarcated line. It is drawn by the Chinese government, according to which it says everything falling within this region belongs to the China. And please note that various countries falling in this region do not consider this line to be a legitimate one. Okay, going further, we have the Cam Ranh Bay, which is located on the eastern side of the Vietnam. And next on the southern side, on southwestern side of South China Sea, we have Gulf of Thailand. And going further, we have Malaysia and Natuna Islands, which were recently in news. Why? Recently, the Chinese military chased away the fishing boats of Indonesia from this region. Okay, next what we have is Strait of Malacca, which is between Malaysia and Indonesia. Well, please note here that the equatorial line passes through Indonesia. And further, we have the Java Sea in this region. And going further, above Indonesia, we have Malaysia. Between Malaysia and Philippines, we have Sulu Sea. And on the western side of Philippines, we have Spratly Islands, which is a contested region between the China and Philippines. And above, we have Luzon Strait and Taiwan Strait here. Please revise these places once or twice because UPSC is fond of asking questions based on maps. And also note that we also have Brunei here, but as of now, it does not have any boundary dispute over the South China Sea with China. So even Brunei can be included in the list of countries surrounding the South China Sea. So what is the dispute all about? Please note that it is a dispute over sovereignty claims by various countries over islands, maritime regions, including small atolls, rocky outcrops, reefs, etc. So who claims what in this region? What are the various regions claimed by countries surrounding this region? See, firstly, China claims by far the largest portion of this territory, that is everything falling within the 9 dash line, including Paracel Islands and Spratly Islands. Next we have the Vietnam, which claims sovereignty over regions including the Paracel Islands. Next we have the dispute between Philippines and China over a region called as Scarborough Shoal, which is about 150 kilometers west of Philippines. And next we have Malaysia, which claims a small number of islands from the Spratly Islands. And so far, there was no such dispute between the China and Indonesia. However, it all started with Chinese aggression in the Natuna Islands. And we also have Brunei here, which stakes no claim in this region. But what is the legal basis for all these claims, which has led to this dispute? See, the dispute all begins because of the rules set forth by the UN clause, which is the United Nations Convention on the Law of the Sea. See, basically the UN clause defines the rights, responsibilities of nations with respect to their use of world's oceans and also establishes guidelines for business, environment and the management of marine natural resources. So it became effective from the year 1982. And more popularly, it is also called as the Law of the Sea Convention or the Law of the Sea Treaty. And this law, which concluded in 1982, came into force on 1994. And there are more than 165 member countries. The demarcation of ocean region as per the UN clause can be seen here. See, as per the UN clause, the region from the territorial sea baseline can be divided into three regions. One is territorial sea, second one exclusive economic zone, and the third one high seas. In the first place, we have the territorial sea, which extends from the baseline for about 12 nautical miles. And this region is also called as state or territorial coastal waters. Here, sovereignty of that individual particular state extends to the airspace, water column, seabed and subsoil, and it allows for the right of innocent passage. And secondly, we have the exclusive economic zone, which extends for about 200 nautical miles. And within this region, we have something called as the contiguous zone, which is also called as the limited enforcement zone. And next thing is important here, that is, within the exclusive economic zone, the countries have sovereign rights for exploring, exploiting, conserving and managing both living and non-living resources of the water column and underlying continental shelf. And beyond 200 nautical miles, we have high seas, which is the water column beyond national jurisdiction. So as per the UN clause, region extending from the baseline up to 200 nautical miles in the sea falls under the jurisdiction of that respective country. And precisely, this has been the main reason for contention between these countries. So, as per the UN clause, many of the regions which are under the national jurisdictions of various countries in this region is claimed by China as per its 9-dash line. And going further, China has also been busy constructing some artificial islands in the region to further its claim on the exclusive economic zone as per the UN clause. However, this is not legitimate as per the UN clause. And in 2016, the Permanent Court of Arbitration had ruled against the Chinese presence in the region. It was a dispute involving both China and Philippines. The court had observed that China cannot legally claim historic rights over the islands in the sea falling within the 9-dash line, and China has violated sovereign rights of Philippines by doing so. So in essence, the ruling said that according to UN clause, any jurisdiction over ocean space derives solely from the jurisdiction over land. That is, one can have jurisdiction over territorial sea from coast, that is up to 12 nautical miles, and from continental shelf up to 200 nautical miles. So clearly, first by constructing artificial islands and secondly by claiming the rights starting from these islands, China has violated the principles of UN clause. And also, when countries become a part of UN clause, earlier historical claims had to be given up. So this essentially negates any legal basis of the 9-dash line. And further, the ruling also said one cannot claim any territorial sea or the exclusive economic zone on the basis of sovereignty over islands which are uninhabited and can't support human life or which submerges in high tide. So many of the islands which are claimed by China do submerge during high tides. However, what is to be noted here is that China has negated this ruling and has further said that since the Permanent Court of Arbitration does not have an enforcement mechanism, it is not going to follow these orders or this ruling. So the last question we have is, what is the importance of South China Sea? The reasons are quite simple. Firstly, it is one of the world's most strategically vital maritime spaces and more oil passes through here than the Suez Canal. And according to estimates, tanker traffic through the Strait of Malacca leading to the South China Sea is more than 3 times greater than the Suez Canal traffic. Further, more than $5 trillion worth trade flows through this region. This is 1/3 of all global maritime commerce. But why is this region or stability in this region is important for India? See, more than 55% of Indian trade passes through the Straits of Malacca, which opens into the South China Sea. Therefore, India has a huge stake in ensuring freedom of navigation and overflight in this region. But despite having commercial interest in the region, India follows the policy of not involving in disputes between the sovereign nations. So India has left for the countries to solve this dispute among themselves. So this was in brief all about the dispute surrounding South China Sea. So if I missed out anything, please do mention in the comment box below. Now based on today's discussion, try to solve a question. This is from prelims perspective. South China Sea is bordered by 1. Japan, 2. Brunei, 3. Taiwan and 4. Malaysia. Choose the correct answer using the quotes given below. You can comment your answers in the comment section below. And please don't forget to like and share this video. Thank you.